everyone, and thank you for joining us for another special of eTown's Campus News. I'm Will Patterson.
And I'm Zach Kleindienst, reporting from Steinman Hall. And here's what's happening now at eTown.
eTown wants to remind students to please take note that treatment of broadleaf weeds will take place on campus lawns this week, as weather conditions allow. Treated areas will be marked with signs, and once the application is dry and the signs are removed, the area is safe for normal use.
The Registration and Records Office would like to announce the Winter 2017, Spring 2018, and Summer 2018 courses are available online and on JWeb for viewing. The advising period runs October 25th to November 10th. Registration begins November 13th.
Due to ongoing work at the Young Center, a power outage will affect Leftward Chapel Monday, October 16th from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. A similar outage will also take place Monday, October 23rd, once again affecting Leftward Chapel, from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. All times are approximated, and the college apologizes for any inconvenience.
Did you know the Study Abroad office has evening office hours? If you can't make it to the Study Abroad office during business hours, stop by on Monday or Wednesday evenings from 7 to 9 p.m. in Nycary 118. This is a great opportunity to pick up some program information, ask questions to recent Study Abroad alumna, and gain assistance picking the right program for you. If you have any questions, please email studyabroad@etown.edu.
Speaking of study abroad, you can now take advantage of a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Due to a generous award from the Japan-U.S. Friendship Commission, the Japanese program is organizing one of the most economical study abroad programs available on campus in Japan. The trip is 3 weeks during the May term and is open to all majors. This program will cost around $2,200, which includes airfare, accommodation, and travel to all field trips outside and within Tokyo. Email the Study Abroad office for more information.
Students, remember October 18th is the last day to sign up for Into the Streets, Elizabethtown College's campus-wide day of service. This year's theme is Shining Into the Streets, and it will be held on October 28th, 2017. There are many ways that you can be involved. Follow this registration to sign up individually, create a team, or join a team that already exists. But hurry, spots are filling up fast.
Coming up, it's the 50th anniversary of the release of the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. The High Library is holding a program, The Transcendental Beatles, Hinduism in the Music and Lives of John, Paul, George, and Ringo, on Thursday, October 19th at 7 p.m. Join Dr. Jeffrey Long as he explores the Hindu themes in the music and lives of the Beatles. The program is free on the main floor of the library and will feature live music performances of Beatles music by an eTown College student. Contact Josh Cohen at cohenjp@etown.edu if you have any questions.
Now for some homecoming announcements. There will be a study abroad session on Saturday, October 21st at 9 a.m. in Brinzer's Lecture Hall. This session will share how to pay for your study abroad experience, common study abroad myths, the benefits of international education, and more. If you have any questions, please email Megan Bell at bellm@etown.edu.
The homecoming buffet will also be held on Saturday, October 21st, and advance tickets are required. You may pick up tickets in the marketplace during dinner hours, 4:30 to 7 o'clock p.m. on Monday, the 16th of October, through Friday, October 20th.
Lastly, join the choirs and jazz band for the annual homecoming concert on Saturday, October 21st in Leffler Chapel and Performance Center at 2:30 p.m. Concert choir, college community chorus, women's choir, and many more will be performing. You don't want to miss this musical event.
The RA selection process will soon be underway. Information sessions regarding the RA position and selection process will be held around campus. The first meeting is on Monday, October 23rd at 7 p.m. at Ober. For the rest of the dates and meeting areas, feel free to contact Residence Life.
eTown is holding an event called Brawls Across Campus in the Cave on October 23rd, celebrating survivors of breast cancer. There will be speakers, singers, dancers, and more. Then on October 24th, there will be a pink out at the women's soccer game, and everyone is encouraged to attend and wear pink. At halftime, we will be raffling off prizes, and all donations and proceeds will be going to the Feel Your Boobies Foundation.
And now, let's take a look outside the nest. Tensions rise as North Korea issues a warning to the United States and the world. North Korea says the entire U.S. mainland is within firing range, and nuclear war may break out at any moment. This follows a hostile exchange between President Trump and North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un, where President Trump referred to Kim Jong-un as the Rocket Man.
Halloween is coming up, but one costume is really turning some heads. Online retailers were forced to stop selling costumes portraying Holocaust victim Anne Frank. Many people have made many comments condemning the retailers selling the costume. One woman wrote, "Please explain how this is a fun and a Halloween costume." A website that sells Halloween costumes has issued an apology after the negative feedback from customers.
And finally, Star Wars takes their advertising to a whole new level, the gym. Disney released new gym gear, including Stormtrooper helmet weights and a Death Star medicine ball. So, clearly, the Force can be with you when you work out.
And that's it for us. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Zach Kleindienst.
And I'm Will Patterson. Have a great day, everyone.